Leah here from Leah4sci.com, and in this video I will show you how to name ketones. The ketone functional group can be recognized when you see an R group bound to a carbonyl carbon and then bound to another R group. The second R group can be the same as the first for a symmetrical ketone or different for an asymmetrical ketone. A carbonyl is simply a carbon double bound to an oxygen and can occur in the beginning, middle, or end of your chain, depending on the functional group in question. Don't confuse the ketone functional group with that of an ether, which is simply RO bound to R prime without that carbonyl present. To name a ketone, you follow the rules for standard IUPAC naming and add the suffix O-N-E or ON to your molecule. Let's start with a simple example. My first step is to identify and highlight my parent chain. In this case, because the molecule is symmetrical, I can choose the number from the right or the left. Since I have a total of three carbons, I get a first name of prop. Since I only have single bonds on my carbon chain, I have the last name of ane. Since my carbonyl or carbon double bound to oxygen shows up at position 2, I include the suffix 2-one. However, since a ketone cannot be on the end of the chain, the number 2 will be understood. If I try to draw this molecule with a carbonyl on the end, I wind up with an aldehyde rather than a ketone, and therefore the number 2 for ketone will be understood on a 3-carbon chain. This allows me to drop the 2 and also drop the E, given that one starts with a vowel, for a final name of propanone. A substituted ketone is treated the same way, where you first identify and highlight your parent chain. You have the option of numbering from the right, giving ketone number 2, or numbering from the left giving methyl number 2. However, since ketone is a higher priority, it gets the lower number, and so I number from the right. With 4 carbons in my parent chain, I have a first name of butte. Having only single bonds on the chain gives me a last name of ane. My ketone shows up on carbon 2, giving me a suffix of 2-one. My 1 carbon substituent at position 3 gives me a prefix of 3-methyl. When putting the name together, you start with your prefix, first name, last name, and then your suffix. However, you can pull 2 in front of the first name, allowing you to drop the E in ane, for a final name of 3-methyl-2-butanone. Let's try a more complex example. In this case, it appears as if my parent chain is only 6 carbons long. However, don't be fooled by what appears to be a stray chain and instead go for your longest continuous carbon chain. My parent chain, in fact, has a total of 7 carbons. I have the option of numbering from bottom right to give methyl number 2 or top left to give the ketone number 2. Since ketone is higher priority, I start numbering from the left and get a total of 7 carbons for a first name of hept. Since I only have single bonds in my parent chain, I get a last name of ane. My carbonyl shows up on carbon 2, giving me a suffix of 2-one. My 2-methyl substituents occurring on carbon 5 and 6 gives me the prefix 5,6-dimethyl. When putting this name together, I have my prefix. I pull the number 2 in front of my first name and then last name, allowing me to drop the E for a final name of 5,6-dimethyl-2-heptanone. When your ketone shows up in a cyclic compound, you treat it the same way. And if it's the only substituent, you don't have to include the number because one will be understood. In this case, we have 6 carbons for a first name of hex. The ring gives me the prefix of cyclo, and only single bonds gives me a last name of ane. My ketone would be 1-one, however the number 1 is understood and therefore omitted, for a final name of cyclohexanone. When your molecule has 2 ketones, you treat it the same way, but simply include the word di in front of your suffix. In this case, we start by highlighting and identifying our parent chain. Having 5 carbons gives me a first name of pent. The fact that it's in a ring gives me a prefix of cyclo. Having only single bonds gives me a last name of ane. Given that I have more than just a single ketone on the molecule, I have to number so that both functional groups get the overall lowest priority, thus giving my ketones number 1 and 3. Since the ketones occur at both carbons 1 and 3, I get a suffix of 1,3-di-one. The 1 and 3 tell me where each ketone shows up, and the di tells me that I have 2. When putting the name together, I pull the 1 and 3 before the cyclo, however I don't drop the E and A, given that di is a consonant and separates my two vowels, for a final name of 1,3-cyclopentanedione. Let's take a look at this example that has both a ketone and a double bond in the ring. We start by highlighting and identifying the parent chain, and then number to give the higher priority group the lower set of numbers. Since a carbonyl is higher in priority than a pi bond, the ketone gets the number 1, and then we continue numbering so that the pi bond get the next lowest set of numbers. Having 6 carbons in my ring gives me a first name of hex. The fact that they're in a ring gives me the prefix cyclo. Since I have a pi bond in my ring, I get a last name of 2-ene. A carbonyl on number 1 gives me a suffix of 1-one. For a final name of cyclohex2-ene-1-one. For the last example, we'll look at a molecule that has both a carbonyl and a hydroxyl occurring at the second carbon in the chain. We'll start by highlighting and identifying the parent chain, and then decide which way to number. If I number from the right, I give a high priority hydroxyl number 2, but numbering from the left gives my ketone number 2. Since ketone is a higher priority than an alcohol, the alcohol gets demoted from a functional group with an OL suffix to a substituent with a hydroxy prefix, which means I have to number from the left. Numbering from the side of the ketone, I have a total of 8 carbons in my ring, giving me a first name of oct. Having only single bonds gives me a last name of ane. Since the alcohol is a substituent, I get the prefix 7-hydroxy, and the ketone my functional group, giving me a suffix of 2-one. This gives me a final name of 7-hydroxy-2-octanone.
Are you struggling with organic chemistry? Are you looking for information to guide you through the course and help you succeed? If so, download my ebook, 10 Secrets to Acing Organic Chemistry, using the link below, or visit leah4sci.com/orgosecrets. That's O-R-G-O secrets. For information regarding online tutoring, visit leah4sci.com/orgotutor. That's O-R-G-O tutor. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and even share it with a friend or two. If you have any questions regarding this video, leave a comment below or contact me through my Facebook page at facebook.com/leah4sci. There will be many related videos posted over the course of the semester, so go ahead and click the subscribe button to ensure that you don't miss out.